when you're skating down the ice and the boards are moving by, or you're moving by the boards that are quicker to speed, when you have to look down, look up, do turns. That space and motion system is exactly the system that was affected in Sid's injury. Sid is a Ferrari. His vestibular system is better than anyone else's. That's why he is the most elite hockey player in the world. That system is where Sid excels at. That system is why Sid is who he is. It makes sense that where his injury was, it's going to take a while to rehabilitate this. And we've done a very good job of doing that. I don't look at concussion as the boogeyman here. I think this is a manageable injury, and we're making progress in Sid's case, and I anticipate Sid returning to hockey and playing well in the future. But I can guarantee you that we're not going to make any mistakes in this case. And before Sid goes back to play, we're going to make sure he's 100% recovered, no ifs, ands, or buts about it. Fortunately, we have very good ways of assessing that. We understand what to look at, what systems to measure and assess, what symptoms to ask about. We understand the influence of his exertion on those symptoms. And we understand what we have to achieve before we can put Sid back in harm's way and where he's going to take another hit. And when he does, we want to make sure that this is fully resolved. I can tell you that over the course of the summer, we initially rehabilitated Sid to the point where he became more active, started to skate, was doing well. We got to that 80 to 90% level of exertion, and as he increased his speed playing hockey, as he increased his turns, as he increased his motion, the symptoms started coming back again. At that point, and even with all the rehab we had done, Dr. Carrick became involved. And Dr. Carrick is an expert in rehabbing these types of injuries and these types of symptoms. And Sid saw Dr. Carrick, and recently Sid has made exceptional progress towards improving into becoming normal. At this point in time, yesterday, actually, I assessed Sid. I haven't assessed him for a while. I was able to assess him and do the testing that we do. And I can tell you that his data is the best we've seen. It is approaching normal limits. It is not there yet. It's something that I was extremely encouraged by with the numbers that we saw, that I saw on impact. I'm very pleased with where he's at right now from an activity standpoint. Right now, I would classify Sid's case as we're in reconditioning mode. In order for Sid to go back to play, he needs to be reconditioned 100% without having symptoms. So let's get him reconditioned and see how he does. At that point, if he can recondition and his symptoms are not there, we will then have a systematic process regarding return to play. There's no timelines on this. We cannot predict when that's going to occur.